A1. This is about, I think it's about 200 miles up to Scarborough, where I'll be staying. We're only about, I think we're about 80 miles to Humber. So this is a place called Great Casterton. It's quite a nice village. Shall I just turn around and go through it again? Not sure why everybody's going so slow. This is a place called Essendine, not far from Rutland, I think. Stamford, maybe. Place is called Bourne in Lincolnshire. It's quite nice, leafy. Nice to see big trees lining the sides of the roads. Don't see that everywhere. Lots of greenery. Trees and stuff. A place called Folkingham. Let's see there. Oh, no, don't need to do that. There you go, that was Folkingham. Just gone past Lincoln and we're heading to the Humber Bridge. It's a grand canal though. So we're coming up to the Humber Bridge. The other side of the Humber Bridge is Hull. This is the Humber Bridge. I'm assuming it goes over the River Humber. And this is Humber Side. This side because mert bikes are free. I think it's only like £2 anyway. We've made it to Bridlington. This is the first town that I will tour on the coast. We just got to go through here. I think we're going to go through the town centre. See if we can find the sea. Let's have a look. So up there is Scarborough, I should imagine, a bit further up, around that headland. That's a nice walkway. Bike's made it. Only got a rucksack. Yeah. So this is Feely. Okay, following this round. This is just south of Scarborough. It's on the same coast. Have a look. Oh, that's a bit steep, that. We can go both ways. Let's go this way. It's quite a nice flat, sweeping beach. Pitch and putt. So that was Feely. Got a nice little cobbled street back up here. It looks very nice. Been this way. So we have finally reached Scarborough. I think I'm entering from the south, so I need to go all the way to the other side, to the north, before we finish, so we get to look at the town. they're here. That'll do. Morning. It's day two. I'm in Scarborough. And today we're going to go north a bit up the coast to Robin Hood's Bay. We're going to go to Whitby. And then we're going to head inland around the North York Moors, mostly the east side. Do try and do the west side tomorrow. Don't want to do too much today. It's a bit cloudy. I think it's going to be a rain-free day, but you never know. They've just turned off to Robin Hood's Bay, so we're heading east into the sun, and we should see the coast. Version. I don't think he knows where he's going. Ooh, it's a fjord. We're all good. Just keep going. Was that my first ever fjord? Actually, I think it's a ford. Robin Hood's Bay, not really much to see if I don't get off my bike. I'm not planning to get off it because I want to just ride. But looks a nice enough village. I can't believe the blue sky. All the clouds burned off. Actually, I wonder if the clouds are still over in Scarborough. Oh yeah, it still looks a bit. Still looks a bit cloudy in Scarborough. We're going to keep heading north, and we're going to Whitby. Oh, it's windy again up here. village called Horska. Busy in Whitby. We'll go right up here. Some nice big houses. Going to the coast, I think we are. Well, I say the coast, I mean to the actual edge. Yeah, looks like we are. And this way. So I plan all these journeys and I never really know where I'm going. Which sounds really good when I'm in my office working it all out. Until I actually get here. I don't know what it's like. Oh, look at that. So this is Westcliff. This is alright. That's a good decision. Well done. Big crescent. Should we go that way or that way? Let's go that way. Whalebone Arch. Go straight round. Not sure if we can go straight round. Stick it in there. There. So we were over there earlier. The other side. So I've just had a little look round Whitley Bay. Sorry, not Whitley Bay, Whitby. This is the West Cliff. Yeah, that's alright. I find with a lot of East Coast England, there's a lot of cliffs, there's a lot of erosion. But a lot of history though. This is a very old town, or city, or town I think. But, so we're heading inland now. We're gonna go and have a bit of lunch somewhere, find a pub. I don't want to overdo it. Saltburn sounds familiar. Is that where we go? Probably not. No, I had to put my wind jacket on today. It's a bit chilly, but it's not uncomfortable. That's a nice view. Another bay. Look, that's cool. This helmet is quite a noisy helmet. I don't think it's as enclosed as my full face. I can't remember what this is called. It's a shark open face helmet, but it's got a chin guard. But it's not as sealed under the chin. So it gets a bit breezy. Crossing over this bridge here somewhere. Beachy. High seas breaking the seawall. Wow, that is high. Danger from heavy seas. Jesus. What, that gets over that? It's got to be 5 meters high. I think we're going up there somewhere. I think we've got a switchback somewhere. Oh, maybe not. I've got to do it now and again, otherwise what's the point of having this bike? Also, I think having the rucksack on my back helps restrict the ventilation in this jacket, so it can actually keep me warm. Just let the air flow through. Although when I get really hot, I might have to take the rucksack off. Is this place called Lille? Lich, Lickle, Lithe. That's nice. Let's go to the village. Going the right way. Yep. Ooh, watch out. Cows. Something about yellow in the English countryside that really stands out. You think it would be green, but it's not, it's yellow. The oilseed rape fields in England, and this heather as well. Oh, baby lambs, slow down. So I'm assuming this is more the moors, more of the moors. Outside Danbury and going into the actual countryside. It's a lot more farming here than I thought. It's a lot more pasture and sheep and cows. There is a lot of moorland up top. See? Yeah, there's a lot of people parked up as well, I've noticed. We have had a little bit of rain. Not a lot though, just a bit of drizzle. Just had a bit of lunch. Nice steak pie at the Jack and Jill. Tiny little birds, like warblers. Bunny. You probably can't spot those on the camera. Oh look, lapwing. See that lapwing? White belly, green top. So riding a motorbike probably isn't the best way to do bird watching. Lovely valley view. I haven't seen many sheep out in the moor, on the actual moor. I've seen them just outside the villages. But I think the sheep have free rein, they can walk anywhere. This looks like it's been burnt off. Yep. Oh, yep, 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 yep. We get a bit faster along here. A bit pongy. Wow. So I feel like we're kind of coming back the way we came. Just over the other side of the field there was a road that we've just been down. I did a bit of a strange double right. I'll kind of go back on myself a little bit. We were looking down that valley earlier. But such is the nature of my map creating. I do tend to loop that up and down a little bit. I'm trying to go from north to south, but I think it's necessary to take some odd routes. Egton. Doing it, giving way. Down here. Is it just following it right? Yep. Went over the river. We've got a nice little river there. Grossmount in the North York Moors National Park. I believe that's the steam railway somewhere along there. Oh, there's a railway line. Oh, it's a level crossing. Whoa. Was he going to run me over? Might as well stop here. Look at that, a model shop. Wow. That doesn't look every day. Oh. Hill. Oh, this is a climb. Okay, so a little quick turnaround. We're going to go this way. Lots of hill climbs. Gothland. Oh, I think we could probably do that in. Thought I was going to stall it then. Got to be careful. And it's all sunny again. The weather certainly changes on the moors. Do you know, when I did this on the map, I didn't realise we were going up and down so many hills. Which is, yeah, I mean, it's the moors, isn't it? You kind of expect it to be a bit hilly. But I didn't. I just literally looked going from north to south. And, hey, hey-ho, but we are definitely on their season walls again. So bleak. Lots of birdies flying about in front of me here. Sheeps. Oh, rams. Lapwing. Seen lots of lapwings. Lonely sheep. Do female sheep have horns? I'm not sure. Another lapwing over here. Flying about. They're ground nesting birds, so they obviously nesting just by the in the heath here. Actually, I mean, there's no trees, so pretty much every bird that's nesting here is going to be nesting on the ground, isn't it? Pickering. Modern pickering. No, I could go at Whitby that way, but I'm going to go to Pickering. There. It's like a huge concrete, I don't know what it is. It looks concrete, but it's not a house. Maybe I'll go and have a look at it. See what it is. I mean, crikey, we are doing 40 miles an hour and you still want to overtake me. A bit obsessed with what that is over there. Nice valley with the sun on it. Nice big black cloud over there. I think that's where I've got to go. What do you think that is? Are we going over or under? Blimey. We're certainly going down. Over. Oh look, it's a, like a steam. What's this place called? Oh, this is Gothland. Or Gotland. Is this is that where that TV show is recorded? Oh, Dr. Beeching. Is that what's is that where that this is filmed? Into that monolith, whatever it is. Do you see it over there? You might be going right past it. You can see the roads along the tops of the hills. There's one over to the right there, and there's one right at the top of that hill. Oh fuck, 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 fuck. I wasn't looking where I was going. Oh my god. Oh dear. Maybe less narration, a little bit more looking where I'm going. That could have been a nasty crash. Got to wait for my adrenaline to calm down now. Ah. and relax. I feel like I've just been this way, but I think this is just another... Oh no, we went over, didn't we? So this is under. Same railway line, different bridge. Oh, sheep in the road. Beep, get out of the way. So these are sheep in the road. And little lambs. Oh look, it's right in front of us. We're still going to Pickering. I wonder what that is then. That's some sort of radar tower? Or what else could it be? It looks like it's some sort of listening device. Rydale. Oh, I thought I saw an ambulance. RAF, there you go. RAF. Filingdales. Like a sound mirror or something like that. Ministry of Defence. What is it with people? I'm doing, well, what's the speed limit? I'm getting 60 probably. So this is a village called Lockton. Quite a sleepy village. Oh, I would say it's actually like a hamlet actually. It's very, a bit smaller than I thought. God, tiny little river. 20% hill. Get around the corner. Levis, yeah. This is another in this place. Nicely, neatly laid out. It's like it was planned. Where are we going next? I think I was meant to go that way. Follow through. Go a bit slower than normal, I think. Oh my god. Lemmies. don't you run out in front of me. What a strange road. This better not be a dead end. I'm hoping that this is a through road. This is called Lewisham Station for the North Yorkshire Moor Railway. No, don't give me this. Keep going. Ooh, look at this. Tell me I've got to go all the way back again. Oh look, we get to see the train. Don't cross. Like a diesel. Anybody on it? I only saw one fare-paying passenger. So it looks like I have to go back the way I came. This is a dead end, or it takes you to a kind of path. I'll get you that. This is the station we were just watching. There's some carriages down there. This looks good, doesn't it? That little signal. Carriages to look at, but we do have to go past all the sheepies again. Just all stay there. Oh great, what are you still doing here? Morning, morning. Back again, out in the North York Moors. I'm on the west side today. Just riding over to Castleton. Just left Danbury. So kind of where we were a little bit yesterday. A little bit less heather down here. We're in the kind of low area at the moment. So Whitby's to my right, and this is Castleton. Big draggled sheep. bit of civilization. Co-op. Some nice houses. As soon as you get off the main road, it's farmland. Tractors and sheep. There's a jump. And probably up the other side, all steep again. Bridge. Yeah, train line. Alright, where are we going? I'm going left to Westerdale. Any cars coming? Nope. A lot of pine forests, those little clumps of pheasant. This is a village called Kildale. About 30 seconds to go through. Yeah, Kildare. Oh well, I'm sorry. Trees over this side. green will be green later. Nice vistas through the trees, through the tree-lined hills, sweeping roads. It's quite a drop. I keep eating flies. I've not got my visor down. Horseflies, it's bumblebees, and today it's a blue bottle and stuff like that. No, I don't know about. So I just had a spot of lunch, and now we're going south to the edge of the North York Moors. A place called Rival or Rye Volks. I don't know how to pronounce it. I think there's an abbey or there's something to see. I think I'm climbing up a bit out of the valley again. It's a lot more wooded area over the west side. A lot more trees and hedgerows and stuff. A bit more like farmland over this side. So I've just turned off to this Revu Bank, Revox Bank, Volks. Sort of dropped into a valley. It's very high. Cliffs, but rock formations to the left and right. This looks nice. Church. What have we got here? Parking. Abbey. Wow. Yeah, so I just stopped at that Revu Abbey and it was closed. Didn't get in. I mean, it didn't have a roof on it, it looked like a ruin. But English Heritage have decided to close on Tuesday and Wednesday. That's no good. So I took a couple of pictures from the road. And now we're going to go to a different abbey called Byland. Byland Abbey. Or Byland Abbey. I'm being constantly pelted with flies. Pheasant. But I guess that's just the nature of riding through the forest, which we are now. This is very forestry. Well, I don't have a signal, so I don't actually know where I'm going. I need to get up high, catch a signal. I've got no, I haven't even got 3G, not even E. So we'll see how we got on up top here. So this is the road to Byland Abbey. Nice pine forest. A lot of abbeys around here, ruined monasteries. I think they're all 500 years old, aren't they? All can't see down there, is it? So we just left Byland Abbey and we're going to go to Helmsley. This is the last town I'm going to before the end. Need to get some fuel as well. It's been a pretty good trip. I think I prefer the east side because of the bleak moorland, but the trees are nice. I prefer the coastline, I think. It's been a good couple of days. Got to find a route home tomorrow. Not quite sure which way to go. But still should have some good views along the way. This is Ambleforth. Ambleforth? It's nice, isn't it? All these roses around the houses. Yellow field. Smells nice. This is Helmsley. I'm hoping there's a fuel station here somewhere. Oh, let's stop here. conformity. I like that. Morning, morning. It's day four, and we're going home today. I've left my Premier Inn for the last time, and we're heading back down to the North Bay. We'll run along the promenade for a bit, and then we'll head south. It's going to be about 5 hours, I think. I don't think I'm going to go too direct. I may record some of it, I may not. But we'll have to see. It's a little bit cloudier than normal. Normally by 11 o'clock it sort of burnt itself out, but it's a bit cloudy at the moment. But it's not raining. There's the North Bay. Just going around the coastline here, and just noticed all these birds cliff nesting. Seagulls. You wonder where they all go at night. It's up there. Thousands of them. I'm just hoping this actually gives me some sort of route out of Scarborough. And it's not just a scenic drive I've got to turn around at the end. We'll see. Seems quite high up though to get up to there. Alright, so it does look like we can get through here. I was for a minute thinking it was a dead end. But this is Scarborough. There's the marina, or the harbour. It's not really massively busy in the middle of May. Just imagine thousands of kids of ice creams. That's kind of what it would be like in a couple of months. Which way we go? Straight on. View crossing. Casino, fish and chips, jackpots, fudge and nugget, entertainment, bowling, bingo, pubs. Oh, there's an entertainment place, like, oh, slot machines, oh, Ferris wheel. Beach. So this is the South Beach, the other side of the rock. Another leisure centre with more slot machines. Victorian Tramway. Wow, that's a nice hotel. Although I think it might be closed. This is a nice little tram bridge. Cast Iron Bridge. Another bridge. So it's very high up. Scarborough's quite high up, multi-level. Could be a walkway. It might be a walkway. It's a huge bridge for a walkway. So if I had to compare Scarborough to another seaside town, I'd say Ilfracombe, but way better. It's a Victorian resort, holiday resort, but it's really well made up, and I think it's doing well for itself, unlike Ilfracombe. Another bridge. Got some engineering here, aren't they? And that's a long one. Here we go, left. Okay, that's it for me. Thanks for watching. I'll see you again soon.